praise God from whom all blessings flow. And today is the first day of our daily devotions. I want to share with you while the Church of Uganda is worshiping through home cells, family altars, and radio church. This is very important for you to know that we have a God who is our God, and He is our friend and our Father. Please also call somebody today to encourage them, and don't forget to initiate community singing because it's very, very important. 2 Chronicles chapter 7, verse 11 to 14 says, when Solomon had finished the temple of the Lord and the royal palace, and had succeeded in carrying out all he had in mind to do in the temple of the Lord and in his own palace, the Lord appeared to him at night and said, I have heard your prayers, and I have chosen this place for myself as a temple for sacrifices. When I shut up the heavens so that there is no rain, or command locusts to devour the land, or send a plague among my people, if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven and I will forgive their sin and will heal their land. This passage shows us God's solution for a sick nation, and that solution is repentant and faith. King Solomon had spent 7 years building the temple of God on Mount Moriah. The temple was now complete and ready for dedication. It was a great human accomplishment, and all the people had gathered together for this very important occasion. In the midst of this great success, God reminded Solomon that their pride could be their downfall. Yet he showed him the solution of repentance and faith, and this is very important. The same is true for us today. This is a time for us as the nation of Uganda to check on our spiritual life, more especially in this season of Lent. God is calling us to examine ourselves on a personal level and pray a prayer of repentance in the most humble way. Then this God, who is a healer, will hear and accept our prayers and will heal and defend our land from this coronavirus and from the locust plague. It's my humble request and prayer that we all keep calm and pray for God's healing and protection of our country Uganda and the neighboring countries. Remember Jesus' words in John chapter 10 verse 10. I have come so that you may have life in its fullness. Be encouraged, my brothers and sisters, by this, and keep praying, because our God cares in every situation. He will never forsake us or let us down. He is a merciful and healing God. Take courage in Him and lift up your hope in Him, because He is able. Even if there is no medicine now, listen to what one writer says. The end of the rope is not the end of the hope. Our hope and help is in the Lord. Be blessed in the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.